So children, we have seen that the squamous epithelium is only single layered, where it helps in the exchange and absorption. Sometimes this very same squamous epithelial tissue may be bundled up or may be multi-layered. When it is multi-layered, it may not do the filtration process or the absorption process. Then it takes up another function. So since it takes up another function and has a new structure, it is going to be termed as stratified squamous epithelial tissue, or simply stratified epithelial tissue. Now observe closely this structure. Here the squamous epithelium is multi-layered. That means it is very thick in structure. So hence it is acting like a protective covering. So where it is found? It is found as a external protective covering of your body, that is nothing but your skin. So if you see, your skin will not allow any water or gases to enter into our body. So your skin is acting like a gas proof and a waterproof agent. And this is all because of the presence of stratified epithelial tissue. Here as well, the cells are flattened with a centrally located nucleus and a dense cytoplasm. Observe, there is no intercellular spaces in these cells, in between these cells. So now let us move to the next one. This is, in the previous one, if you see, they were flattened in case of epithelial tissue, but here squamous epithelial tissue. But here in another another form of epithelial tissue, you see that these are modified into long pillar-like or column-like structure. Hence, these are termed as columnar epithelial tissue. Column means pillar-like. So now, since they are pillar-like, the surface area is more and the nucleus will be located almost to the basement. Now these, of course, as like squamous, they also lack intercellular spaces, and since they are very much elongated and tightly packed, they are going to help in the absorption and secretion process. So where does absorption and secretion occurs in our body? Yes, in our intestine. So these columnar epithelial tissues are located in our intestine. Sometimes these columnar epithelial tissues may also have some fine strand hair-like structures. Then it is termed as ciliated columnar epithelial tissue. Now since they have these fine hair-like structures, these help in the movement of the particles from in and out of the body. So therefore, these are mostly found in the inner lining of the respiratory tract, that is nothing but your windpipe or trachea, and also found in the female reproductive system, that helps in the movement of the ova through the fallopian tube. So the next two categories are columnar epithelial tissue and ciliated columnar epithelial tissue.